patients go into the hospital, and basically they're put on a machine that can harvest their bone marrow cells. Those are sort of liberated by treating the patient with chemicals that allow those bone marrow cells to sort of migrate out of their bones and into the bloodstream, and they can be captured based on proteins on the surface of the cell. These stem cells are cells that, in the case of the blood system, give rise to all types of blood cells, red blood cells, T cells, B cells, all of those things. And so if you can modify the stem cells and return them to the patient, in principle, they can restore any component of the blood system that's defective. And after the cells are harvested from the patient, they will be essentially treated with Cas9 nuclease. And the way that's done is a process of electroporation, which is you mix the cells with the Cas9 protein and the RNA that programs it to go to a specific address in the genome. You give a quick pulse of electricity. It shocks the cells and opens up some really small holes in them so that the protein can get in. It goes into the cell nucleus, finds the location in the genome where it's supposed to act based on the RNA that's been programmed with, and it'll cut the DNA. And when it cuts the DNA, that'll make a break, and then the DNA repair machinery in the cell will put things back together, but a lot of times it makes errors when it does that. It makes a mistake. And actually that mistake is important in this case because what it does is it disrupts a regulatory element. And a regulatory element you can think of as a command that's within the genome that tells a certain gene to get turned on at a specific time. And in this case, this regulatory element that's getting disrupted no longer tells a particular protein to go and turn off fetal hemoglobin. And since it's not being turned off anymore, it'll be expressed in red blood cells and restore the function of hemoglobin. But now it'll be fetal hemoglobin instead of adult hemoglobin that will be present. And the red blood cells will no longer change shape. They won't sickle. The exciting thing is that if you can manipulate the genome, it offers the possibility of permanent cures for patients who are suffering from disease.